Can I ask you something? Yes. Do you think Jesus is a Muslim?
Yes, he is a Muslim.
Why do you think so?
I don't want to go in much detail why he's Muslim and all of that. I don't want to debate.
Very important.
He is a Muslim. It's written He is Muslim. It's written in the Quran. Quran is the word of God. Simple as that.
So, but you don't have any particular details in relation to why Jesus is a Muslim?
See, you have to make an assessment worldwide. You're getting my point. Like, there are 4 or 5 major religions in the world. So finally, when you reach to a conclusion, either Islam is the right religion or either Christianity. You're getting my point.
So why do you think Islam is the right religion?
See, why...
Give me one good reason why we should discard all of history that we are aware of, and consider Islam to be the true religion. Why?
We should not discard all the history. It's not the Islamic point that we should discard.
Christianity came before Islam.
Now, to claim
that suddenly Christianity is very clear that Jesus is God. Now, Christianity has been around for a number of centuries even before Islam even showed up. For Islam to come and suddenly claim that Jesus was not just God, not just not God, but also that he was a mere Muslim, I'd like to find out why should we discard history for the sake of Islam? What is the reason? What evidence have you got for Islam to be considered the true religion?
I mean, the first thing is you're saying we should discard history. It's not the case. When it comes to Islam, we respect Jesus Christ. We respect Moses. We respect all the prophet before Prophet Muhammad. You're getting my point. So, and then for the first thing is we are not discarding the history. And the second thing is why we shall accept Islam as the one religion, like compared to Christianity.
True religion.
Because the first thing is it makes sense.
In what way? Please give details.
It makes sense. It's preaching, like, for example, there is only one God, which, for example, is a very, basic instinct. For example, a child, for example, a 7 or 8 year child, if you just go and explain to a 7 or 8 year child there a man was a god or there was 3-in-1 and all of that, you're getting my point, he will not agree to that thing.
I don't understand. Have you ever read the Bible in details?
You
haven't read the detail of Christian theology. Please don't even get there. Don't undermine something which you haven't read. So please don't undermine what you haven't read. Don't make it trivial. Because some of the brightest minds have been Christian in human history. Please don't trivialize that. It's not as trivial as that. So let me ask you this very simple question again. What is the evidence to consider Islam alone to be the true religion today? What's the evidence?
You have such a book in your hand and you're saying...
It was revealed to every messenger of God that a prophet will come at the end, which will be he will be the last prophet.
Yeah, please.
Even to Moses.
So this is the Bible. Show me where it says.
It's the corrupted version of the Bible. You come up, it's the Bible.
What's the evidence that the Bible is corrupt?
What's the evidence? This book, we consider it the final book, complete book, without any contradiction, directly from the God, revealed to a prophet who was ill, who was neither able to read and write. You're getting my point? And then this book, which we consider as the truth, it's written inside it that this book is corrupted. And the book which I'm talking about is preserved from 1400 years. It's in the same condition from last 1400 years. The prophecies of Prophet Muhammad are coming true. We can see the prophecies of Prophet.
Let me go back, because I think you're throwing in all sorts of red herrings here. You look like a sensible man. Yeah, but I'd really like to get to some sense here, because so far you haven't given any meat to chew on. You've just made claims after claim after claim. I'd like to find out evidence. You know, anyone can show up here and say you are a murderer, you are a thief, you are this, you are that. What's the evidence you have that this is a true religion? Islam is a true religion. What's the evidence you have?
Quran is the evidence.
Explain.
Quran, the book which is preserved from last 1400 years in its form, revealed to Prophet Muhammad, not changed. There is no any contradictory thing in it. It's being revealed by the God. This is the evidence.
In other words, your one claim right now, one argument right now, is that the preservation of this text is the evidence.
That is the one evidence.
That's the one you've given so far. Good. We'll see if it is a fact or not. That's the one claim you have made so far.
Enough.
Let's see. Let's see if that.
See why? Just bring a counter to it.
Well, I'm going to right now. So your claim is, your argument is to back up the claim that the preservation of the Quran means it's from God. Let me ask you this very simply. Are you suggesting just because some book is preserved, even if it is preserved, which I don't think is the case at all, I'll get to that in a minute. Are you saying if a book is preserved, it is from God? Is that what you're saying?
From last 1400 years, the book.
So now you want time period included. Are you saying if a book is preserved for 1400 years, then it must be from God? Is that what you're saying?
Somehow, yeah, I'm trying to.
So if I show you a book from before the time of Jesus, some manuscripts right now. So one second.
There is no any contradictory thing.
You're veering away right now.
This is the one thing, but the second thing.
I'd like to stick to one thing, because otherwise you can be jumping from one place to another and none of them might be true. So one thing. Can we please very quickly agree? I'm sure you'd be able to quickly agree that logically speaking, just because a book is preserved, even if it is true, I don't think that is true at all, I'll come to that in a minute. But even if it is true, just because a book is preserved, it does not mean it is from God. I can show you a number of books.
No, you cannot.
Outside, like from have you ever heard of, have you ever?
Tell me any book which is preserved from last 1400 years. Tell me
anyone. I can tell you.
Yeah, just tell me anyone.
Okay. So if you, are you aware?
Not able to tell me.
Are you? Oh, tell me. Are you aware of Dead Sea Scrolls?
So you mean this is preserved? The book is preserved. You're saying the book is preserved.
There are a number of books.
Just tell me one book.
There are a number of.
Tell me one book.
There are a number of books. A number of books in what is called the Dead Sea collection.
Okay, great.
Let me finish. There are a number of books which are today called what is called the Dead Sea Scrolls, a collection. Some of which are biblical books, some of which are not biblical books. I can name one for you, which we have even from before the time of Jesus. We can have a copy. Oh, the War Scroll.
The War Scroll is a book which is preserved.
Yeah, which is, we have.
Okay. You mean preserved. Like, how many people do you know that they have literally memorized the book? From 2000
now years. You're veering away.
No, you're veering away.
Do you know when an argument is a logically sound argument? When you claim something, you don't have to make things up as you go along. One second. When you don't have to make things up as you go along, you can stick to the original argument.
I can say 1,000 things without backing it with evidence. Can you back this thing with evidence that you said the book is preserved?
That's fine. I am
backing this thing with the evidence that millions of people have memorized.
Coming to the evidence later. Maybe you're having a short-term memory loss here. Let me repeat what I said earlier. You think you have many reasons, but you began by saying preservation of the text.
Yeah.
Preservation of the Quran means Quran is from God. That's what you claimed. I'd like to just stick to that claim, please. And I ask you, because even that claim doesn't make sense to me, because it is not logically valid to claim, just because a book is preserved, my diary is... Just because a book is preserved, that it has to be from God. That doesn't logically follow. And that is where, I'm giving you an example. You may not be aware.
Exactly.
Are you aware of the Dead Sea Scrolls?
Let's see if I'm aware.
Are you aware of the Dead Sea Scrolls?
Okay, I'm aware of that thing. For example.
Are you aware of the Dead Sea Scrolls?
I'm not aware.
In which case, you're arguing from ignorance, please. You can only...
I will just ask you one more question. You say there is a book which is preserved. You just made a statement. You're getting my point. I'm just asking you, can you tell me the evidence that the book is preserved? Do you have an evidence?
We have a copy.
There
we go. You won't listen. You won't engage.
We have a copy.
You don't engage in an argument. I thought you'd be a sensible man. I don't. I'm taking that comment back. I'm taking that comment back because you're not being sensible right now. You're not being sensible right now.
I'm saying a book is preserved. I make three statements. I said the book is preserved. There is no contradictory evidence in it. And the book has been, for example, how the book has been preserved? It has been memorized by millions of people.
What's the evidence that anyone memorized the Quran during the time of Muhammad? What's the evidence that anyone memorized the Quran during the time of Muhammad?
Is the evidence
sir?
Quran itself is the evidence that it's
Quran is a, you, I ask you for the Quran, you talk about the memorization. I'm asking you again, please. Maybe you didn't listen carefully. I'll repeat this. What is the evidence that the Sahaba, any or all of the Sahaba, memorized the Quran?
I'm really sorry. Then if you are asking this question, that means you don't want to, like, for example, if
what
you,
is it? Do you have an evidence or not?
Now, if
clearly don't
like
have an evidence, you're struggling. It's
like,
time to give up. When you can't provide evidence, time to give up.
For everything, for example, then for example, you can just come up and say, do you have an evidence that the God exists? Like, show me where is God.
You started by saying it's a fact. You see how your husband is struggling right now? I'm asking just a few questions. I'm assuming it's your husband.
Exactly.
Okay. I see. Okay. That's fine.
I respond to your silly question? Now you can, for example, what is the evidence that the book has been memorized by millions of people?
Evidence.
You know.
Evidence.
The evidence is that I...
you are claiming this?
Evidence is what?
The
evidence is what?
Please fill
the evidence. I myself is an evidence I have memorized. Like,
no,
I can listen to my question again.
Sahaba. What's the evidence that the Sahaba memorized the Quran? Any or all of them?
I just want to make make the situation more and more complex, and that's it.
Very simple. What's the evidence that any or all of the Sahaba of Muhammad memorized the Quran?
Now, if you keep asking this type of question, the discussion will keep going on.
Struggling, aren't you?
It's not about...
It's time to give up.
It's not about trying to give up.
One second, my dear friend. Now, when you go home, I'm assuming that's your husband, yeah?
I will suggest...
Yeah. When you go home, just tell him, no, look, this is how we are doing everything. You're not able to back up anything with evidence. This is why we have struggles at home. Please, this is a joke, by the way. Lovely, lovely couple. God bless you. But my important point is the one reason you gave as to why Islam is a true religion, you weren't able to back up. It's a shame, really. It's really a shame. It's a real shame. And therefore...
We don't want to lose our precious words on a fool who wants to argue.
In other words, you haven't given any evidence so far.
Yes, I'm saying Quran itself is an evidence.
This is a silly argument.
Do you think that could work?
Do you think that claim would work? Quran itself?
Without any contradictory thing in it. Memorized by
millions. Are you sure there is no contradiction in the Quran?
It's not about...
Are you sure there is no contradiction in the Quran?
You also know that there is no
contradiction. I can give you one contradiction.
You will try your best.
Can I try?
You will try your best.
Would you engage with that at least?
You will come up with a silly...
Would you at least engage with that? Are you afraid already?
I'm damn sure that... If the question you asked, that if there is any evidence that the Quran has been memorized by anyone in the time of Prophet Muhammad, the silly question which you ask, again, you're going to
it's
bring...
A silly question?
Yeah, it's a silly question.
Asking question
you know
about
this,
history
book,
is silly?
You know that the book...
My dear friend, I am a Christian. Let me do one thing, please. Ask about Jesus Christ, I'll give you plenty of details. Can I please gift you this? Please, this is a gift for you.
Jesus Christ
and the history of Jesus Christ from the first century, solid. Solid.
Jesus.
Yeah.
Take the book. We know more about Jesus Christ in
the
Quran.
You don't read any book, do you? No knowledge of Dead Sea Scroll. Can I give you as a gift?
In the Quran, we know much more details are written.
Can I give you as a gift? Where was Jesus born? Does the Quran give you these details?
The first thing is, I'm not sure whether...
Where was Jesus born? Does the Quran give you details?
Is it important?
Well, you said Jesus...
Is it important for me that where Jesus was born?
Okay, let me repeat what you said earlier. One second. You said earlier the Quran gives much more detail.
I'm assuming, to conclude, Jesus was.
Let me ask you again. Does the Quran give much more detail about Jesus than the Bible or not? Are you going to retract that statement too? Okay, that's fine. In other words, Quran gives some gibberish. What's that?
He was just a messenger of God as Muhammad.
What does the Bible claim?
Bible was revealed to him by God.
What does the Bible claim about Jesus?
Your corrupted version of Bible.
Corrupted version.
Yes. Been changed over years, over centuries. This is not the true version of Bible.
Do you know of any... There are thousands of manuscripts of the Bible today, New Testament today. Do you know of one manuscript... very interesting question. Do you know of one manuscript of a gospel somewhere which claims that Jesus is not God? Anyone?
In Quran, everything.
Not Quran. I'm asking about a manuscript because you mentioned about corruption of the Bible. I'd like to find out if there is one evidence, one manuscript for a gospel which claims Jesus is not God.
Can you give me a single evidence that Bible is not corrupted? It has not been changed.
I can give you.
No, you cannot.
Why you say wow? I'm not like you.
No, you can give.
I'm not like you, my dear.
Made up stories, made up things.
My dear friend, I'm not like you. I asked your husband for evidence. He could not. I completely understand. You are his wife, so you need to make sure your husband has good reputation as he leaves Speaker's Corner. I completely understand. But having said that, I completely see that already. Very much see, because you're not looking for answers to crucial questions. Muslims do this all the time. Let me ask you one question. Do you know?
Just a minute. What's your name? What's your good name?
Arul.
Arul, my name is Nazir.
Nazir.
Nazir. You moved from one thing, for example, we were trying to say that if a book is preserved and all of that, you moved from that already.
Because you did not engage.
Okay, now
because she said she doesn't give evidence for the book.
Now you're trying to say that whether Jesus was God or not and all of that thing.
My dear friend, Nazir, I'll remind you, maybe you're forgetting this again. I asked you, does preservation mean supernatural origin? You could not answer. I asked you, you said, well, that's where memorization comes in. I asked you, do you have evidence for memorization by the Sahabas? You could not give an answer. And at that stage, our friend here, very eloquently to save you, she said, she doesn't give evidence to the fools. So that's where I thought, okay, that's fine, we'll move on. And that is where you said, between you, somehow you made a few comments. You said Jesus is not God, the Bible is corrupt and so on. And there too you are struggling. So it is time really.
You do not want to accept this, that Quran is the main evidence. It is the main fact. It has all the same things. It has
everything about Quran is a Mickey Mouse story. You did not give any evidence for Sahabas memorizing the Quran.
Mickey Mouse story thing. You get my point?
Why not?
Don't use such a slur, honestly speaking.
Why not?
No.
Fantasy story. Could that be a better story, better word, better expression?
I would suggest revert back to Allah, or
just a minute.
How do you call fiction? What is a better term for you? Fiction. Fictitious, a myth. Almost every claim about Islam could be demonstrated to be desperate, false lies, indoctrination. This is where questions are important. Nazir.
We accept
Christianity, but we don't accept
that Jesus Christ is a prophet.
That is not Christianity. You can't have the cake and eat it too. You can't say I accept Islam, but I just think Muhammad is not a messenger.